deal was so frightening and disgraceful, I can almost call it a Chamberlain-like Munich deal. The Arabs, the Iranian Muslims are not being asked to destroy or dismantle any part of the nuclear program. Not their centrifuges, not the uranium, not the heavy water plutonium plant in Iraq. Nothing. In other words, all they're being asked to do is to be stand still for a few months, and then after that, they can continue and move forward with their program. And in response, we're giving them mega billions of dollars in financial monies that they haven't been getting, which will enable them to become part of the world. They're becoming normalized, and there'll be enormous movement by China, Russia, Japan, and Europe to make financial deals with Iran because they want the money. And I will say, this is, as Netanyahu said, a historic mistake. It is actually absolutely frightening. We need not only the people of Israel, but the pro-Israel people of the world, of America, the Christians, the Jews, to speak out against this. We need a major rally in Washington to speak out about against this Churchill, against this Chamberlain Munich-type deal that is endangering not only Israel, but is endangering America, because they're working to get ICBMs, ballistic missiles, that'll have nuclear warheads in the near future that can reach America by 2015. American intelligence has written that, so that must be a fact. So we're going to do all we can on the Hill to urge members of the Senate to invoke new and stronger sanctions now. We can get enough people to support this in the House and the Senate where an Obama will not be able to veto it. And I think that is our priority right now, to make it clear that America does not support this Obama-Kerry-Chamberlain deal.
Are there enough Democrats that you think could side with you more and go against the president?
On sanctions, we're going to work hard, but my fear is they'll say we'll go for sanctions, but they may want to wait 6 months, which is the length of this deal. But that's too long, that's too dangerous, so we're going to work to try and get them to understand. Democrats are becoming somewhat more inclined to go against President Obama because how he betrayed them and betrayed the country on Obamacare, where he lied that people will keep their doctors, keep their plan, and be able to have a $2,500 reduction in their cost. He lied about Benghazi, saying that this was a anti-Muslim film that causes terrorism. We now know that was a lie. And he lied when he said that he had no idea that IRS were going against his political opponents. The Democrats now are running scared that they could lose big in 2014, and many of them are now considering going against Obama, not to go against Obama, but to do the right thing for America and for America's best ally, Israel.
So you think that 2014, the elections, you think there's a good chance that Republicans, because of Obamacare failures and this Iranian deal, might actually jeopardize the Democrats' hold on the Senate?
I think there's an outstanding chance that the Republicans, I'm not saying this is a political partisan, I'm saying this is a political fact, can take back the Senate and have increased their majority in the House. Remember, in a recent poll by Pew, two-thirds of Americans support military action against Iran. They understand the danger to America, not just Israel and Europe. And I think the Democrats are in serious trouble for 2014, which means America will be in much better shape after 2014.
Do you think Saudi Arabia is going to be the wild card in all this?
Coalitions are built on issues that different parties hold that are identical, not on beliefs on every part of their agenda. Saudi Arabia, United Arab Emirates, Yemen, and others are scared to death of Iran getting nuclear weapons. They're afraid they'll use them to take over the oil fields in Saudi Arabia, to take over maybe an entire country. And so on the issue of Iran, many of the major Arab countries are with Israel, and I believe they will support military action if necessary. And it is shocking that Obama has explicitly ruled it out. He said it would be a disaster, military action. He said it only this week, when military action, tragically, is the only now way we can stop it. Military action can bring peace and safety to the world. Non-military action will bring more deaths and war to the world.
What else does this agreement so-called deal, what other effects does it have on the American public, the American people?
Well, God forbid, if Iran gets nuclear weapons, they can put it on ships that'll be coming to American ports. They can put it on trucks that can be in major cities in America. As I said, in a year and a half, they can have missiles that can reach America with a nuclear payload, endangering America. We are at risk, God forbid, of losing hundreds of thousands, even millions of Americans by an attack from Iran, who openly says that we must destroy America in order for the Imam, the 12th Imam, to come and bring Islam as the leading, as the religion of the world. It's very serious. I think more Americans now are going to be to understand that, that we cannot allow a second Chamberlain to prevail. That Americans will now realize that that this is enormous danger. As I said before, if Iran has killed thousands of Americans by terrorist attacks over the last 3 years in 25 different countries, what will they do once they have nuclear weapons? They can wreak much more havoc and much more danger. And I hope that Israel has the strength and fortitude to do what's right, not only for Israel, but for the entire world.